It's not unanimous. Others not so happy. Joining us now to discuss, Ambassador Richard Haass. He is president of the Council on Foreign Relations and author of The World, A Brief Introduction. He served in the George W. Bush administration. Good to have you on, as always. You say among the biggest failures of the Trump administration was damage to American democracy, and I imagine as a result, soft power. Is that rescued by this election? I mean, it's only a couple weeks ago we had people storming the castle, right? the Capitol. How does Biden repair that? Can he repair that, all the damage?
Look, reputations take a long time to build up, whether they're individuals or countries, pretty easy to tear down. It's going to be a while before we dig ourselves out of that. Those images will stay with the rest of the world, and we've got to demonstrate day in, day out, week in, week out, that our democracy can deliver, whether it's effective governance, deal with racism, and any of the other things that have plagued this society for years. I think the rest of the world is hopeful. Yesterday, most of the world will see yesterday, finally the arrows are going in the right direction here. But we've got a long road to go back.
You wrote just a few days ago that Trump's final act has accelerated the onset of the post-American world. And you, what struck me most actually in your piece was you talked about the need for America to be self-aware. Can you explain that a little bit more?
Yeah, I mean, the first half of it was the idea that the rest of the world won't see us quite the same way and won't depend on us quite the same way.
Right.
This could happen once. The fear is it could happen again, whether in four years or some other time. The self-awareness is I think we have to be much more conscious of our own flaws, of our own shortcomings. Enough with this stuff about shining cities on a hill, American exceptionalism. Let's make the place work. Let's make the American dream a reality rather than just a dream. Let's do something with infrastructure, do something about COVID. We've got a long list of things we've got to repair here at home.
Yeah, you've been preaching that for a number of years in a number of books, to your credit, about repairing the issues at home helps build your power abroad. I want to ask you, because certainly many things will change, I mean, from Keystone Pipeline, you know, to commitment to NATO, et cetera. But one thing unlikely to change or change dramatically, right, is the U.S. approach to China, that this more confrontational standing up to China has become something of a bipartisan position, has it not?
It has, and the reason is it's a gentleman named Xi Jinping. The biggest change is not not what happened here. We're reacting to what's happened there. This is a more repressive China. It's a stronger China militarily. It's a more assertive China. And what you've seen, as you say, Jim, across party lines, the United States has essentially come to a different conclusion. Rather than seeing China on a trajectory where it would eventually moderate at home and abroad, we've now concluded that's not going to happen. We have to respond to that.
Your friend and Eurasia Group President Ian Bremmer said last week after the Capitol insurrection, quote, you can't lump U.S. democracy in with Canada, Germany, and Japan anymore. And his belief is that we're now midway between them and Hungary. Do you agree with him? Do you think it changed it that much for a long time?
Look, the answer is we don't know. We'll have to see what happens down there. I don't mean to avoid your question, but I'm worried. I think what happened, not just on January 6th, but over the previous years, is real. We don't teach civics in this country. We have increasingly a world of narrowcasting rather than broadcasting. People live in communities and go to churches where their own views are reinforced. So at 70-odd million people, 75 million people voted for Donald Trump, despite his attacks on the courts, on the media, and you name it. So, yeah, I think the question of the future of U.S. democracy is very much in play. As good as yesterday was, no one can do the sigh of relief.
Before we go, a lot of talk here in this country, and you've said this too, job number one, right, is addressing the pandemic at home. But abroad, what would you say is the most important first step for him, first challenge to face abroad?
Getting the pandemic under control. It will show a reassertion of American competence. Getting the economy back would then follow. Showing that American politics are being conducted politically rather than physically. We can do that, a lot of good things will follow. If we can't do that, foreign policy can't compensate.
Ambassador Richard Haass, thank you. We love having you on. Thanks for joining us, especially today.
Thanks for having me. Take care.